In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create this title animation, projecting text all over screens. Hey everyone, my name is Manuel. Let's dive right in and add some text first of all. We grab the title tool up here, which opens the character window. I use BioSans Extra Bold, which is available on Adobe Fonts. Size 200, fill color white. You can use any font of course, it's just one of my favorites. Then, in the paragraph window, we center the text. And with a line, we align the layer itself to the center of the comp. Next, let's quickly animate the layer. We open the transform property and set a scale keyframe at the last frame of the comp, a position keyframe at 12 frames. Then, we go to the beginning and scale it up to around 725%. And we move it to the right, almost out of the screen, so that the first letter remains visible. Then we open the graph editor to edit the speed graph. We slow down the end of both animations as much as possible by moving the points to the zero line and dragging all handles as far to the left as possible. Awesome! A nice and simple animation. Finally, we right-click on the layer and pre-compose it. Name it pre-text. This makes sure we can change the text anytime later without messing up the whole animation. Next, let's create one of the screens. With no layer selected, we double-click on the rectangle tool. Open the rectangle path property, uncheck constrain proportions, and set the size to 250 by 650 pixels. Fill black. Let's name the layer screen background 1. We duplicate the layer, Command or Control D, and rename it. Screen Mask 1. And change the fill color to white. We move the text comp in between these two layers and use the mask as alpha track mat for the text comp. Let's go further to the left to see it worked. Awesome. We want to have at least a hint of color on the screen, right? So we duplicate the screen background again. Name it screen gradient 1. This time we use a linear gradient as fill. Colors from white to blue. And we click on this opacity stop up here and set the opacity to 0. Almost. We click on the right stop and set it to around 40%. Awesome. Let's use these two blue handles to adjust the start and end position, so that it turns blue towards the bottom right corner. Next, we want to simulate a shiny and reflective floor. So we duplicate the screen gradient layer, name it screen reflection 1, and move it to the bottom of the layer stacking order. Next, we choose the anchor point tool, and move the anchor point towards the bottom edge of the shape, while holding command or control until it snaps to the middle point. Then we go to layer, transform, and choose flip vertical. For my taste, the reflection is much too strong, so we reduce the opacity of the layer to around 50%. Then we select the layer, the rectangle tool, and switch to tool creates mask here, to add a mask, roughly around the bottom edge. We open the mask property, deselect constraint proportions, and add a vertical mask feather of around 250 pixels. We created a nice and subtle reflection. Finally, we link all layers except the text comp to screen mask 1, which is on top. This is the layer we're gonna animate. I think it would be great if all the layers had the same label color. And we turn all layers except the text comp into 3D layers. And we set the shy switch for all layers except the top two layers. What that does is it hides all layers for which this option is active, which will be very useful later. Another thing that is really helpful is my newsletter, which I recently started. It'll help you to improve as a motion designer. Link is in the description below. And there might be an exclusive freebie waiting for you. Now we need more screens, right? Easy. We duplicate all layers, move them below, and change the label colors. It is much easier like that to keep the screens apart. Then open the position property of screen mask 2 and move it to the left. And we need to relink the mask. Use screen mask 2 instead of mask 1. We repeat that a few times until we have like 7 screens. The number is totally up to you, of course. Awesome. Then we activate shy, which hides all the layers we don't need right now. Great. Next, we go to the end of the timeline, the final position. And first of all, position all the screens. I want the middle one to be the biggest and closest one, so I move it to the front. The ones left and right of it a bit behind. And so on, so that the outer ones are the furthest away. Alright, next we need to project the text all over it. So we start in the middle again. Scale it up. You can see that the quality gets really bad. So we need to continuously rasterize it. Let's move on with the other screens. I think it should look like it's a bit all over the place. Not done perfectly, like sloppy work. Awesome. As a little detail, we could add Gaussian blur effects to the two most left and right letters, with a blurriness of around 4 to 10, to simulate that the projection is slightly out of focus. Next, we need a bright foreground to add more depth to the scene. We add a new solid, Command or Control Y. We name it foreground. Solid color, a very bright purple. We move it to the bottom of the layer stacking order, but keep in mind to make all layers visible to be sure it really is at the bottom. Again, we use the rectangle tool to add a mask around the bottom edge. Open the mask property to add a vertical mask feather of around 500 pixels. One more thing we need is a light. We add another solid to the top, color a bright pink as well. We name the layer, of course, Light. We use the ellipse tool this time to add a round mask somewhere in the upper left part. Add a mask feather again. And set the blending mode of the layer to Add. Then let's add a camera. Well, sort of. We add an adjustment layer. And name it camera, because that's what we use it for. Turn it into a 3D layer. And link all the screen mask layers to it, using the pick whip tool. We open the position and rotation property and set a keyframe for the position and the set rotation at the end. At the beginning, we set the set position to -1400, zoom in very close, and the set rotation to 30 degrees. We open the graph editor and slow down the end of both animations as much as possible. The position and the rotation. The rotation speed graph is upside down because it's a negative value. We add another adjustment layer. Name it noise, maybe. Add Gaussian blur. Set blurriness to 200 at the beginning. Set a keyframe. Press U to see it in the timeline, then set it to 0 at 1 second. Again, we use the graph editor to slow down the end of the animation. Finally, we add noise. Amount 3%, no color noise. Make sure to check out the free project file and join my newsletter. Links are in the description. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye, guys!